Hi, this is Rob Hawley from the Fremont Peak Observatory. One question that I've been asked that was too long for the previous video is to give a really good picture of what's happening in space between the Earth, the Sun, and the Moon. This video updates one I did in 2009 and shows what's happening during the eclipse in 2017. Most people are familiar with this map, which is the track over North America. But that's only a small portion of the total track, which begins north of Hawaii and ends off the coast of Africa. From a time point of view, the eclipse begins about 1649 UTC at sunrise and ends at 2003 UTC at sunset. The eclipse in the US begins about 1715 UTC. Now the first of two simulations using the PC program Seeker. We're above the Earth looking towards the Sun and Moon. It's about 1600 UTC. The shadow of the moon will shortly touch the surface of the Earth. The reason this is happening is because the moon is moving between the sun and the Earth, as you'll see in the next few seconds. This simulation runs about the same length of time as the eclipse is occurring. Now let's go to the moon and look back at the Earth. It's of course a new moon. The side facing the Earth is completely in shadow, and the far side is completely lit. From the moon, the Earth looks completely lit. Now let's travel back to the Earth and watch the eclipse occur. Unfortunately, the Seeker simulation does not give you a very accurate picture of what an eclipse actually looks like from space. So instead, keep in mind this picture from the 2016 eclipse over Indonesia. This picture was taken right about the same time that I was taking my pictures from the ship. Back to the simulation. Shortly you will see a small dot appear right at the terminator line. That represents the eclipse starting at sunrise halfway between Hawaii and Alaska. The eclipse is now over the U.S. We're going to pause the simulation at the point of maximum eclipse. The point of maximum eclipse occurs when the sun is at the meridian. At this point, the Earth is closest to the sun and the moon, which makes the moon appear slightly larger. The result of this is the eclipse is slightly longer here. Let's continue. The track is now moving through the eastern U.S. and shortly will move off into the Atlantic. It will continue in the Atlantic for quite a while until it reaches sunset off the coast of Africa. Let me end by going off the coast of Africa, where the sun is about to set. The shadow of the moon will be approaching from below the horizon, and they will meet at sunset.